told me I was awful and that shit did not faze me. Tell me how I suck again, my memory is hazy. You're my favorite rapper now, yeah, dude, I better be.
Haven't seen pictures of hot girls holding guitars yet today. Let's change that.
Follow your dreams. Yeah. Wanna get a mansion?
Oh no, I hope I don't fall.
No.
Tell me that you're gay without telling me that you're gay.
Okay, first of all, fucking look at me. Second of all, my voice. Third of all, look at my fucking walls. Huh? Huh?
Third of all,
do I need to continue?
Okay.
The confusion and hullabaloo around a lesbian saying that a man is sexy or hot or fine has always confused me. It truly has. You think because I'm gay I cease to have retinas? There are men who are fine. Like, look at the symmetry of their face. They are sexy, point blank period. You got your Idris Elbas, your Daniel Day Kims. They are fine. But there's a difference. There's a difference between seeing that someone is attractive versus being attracted to them. What's not clicking? What is it that's not clicking? I'm confused. Women have girl crushes all the time and nobody goes, I thought you were straight. You know, gay men say a woman is sexy. Nobody goes, I thought you were gay. So where is that energy for lesbians? Where's that energy? End of the day, if he rolled up to me and said, yo, I think you kind of cute. You want to grab dinner? No, sir. I'm sorry, sir. You go be sexy in the corner and leave me alone. Get away from me. Thank you.
Ce que tu touches, tu le détruis. Mon corps se couche sur ton ennui. J'ai fait l'impasse sur les mots doux. Comme une terrasse en plein mois d'août. Fais pas semblant car je le sais. Tu ne m'aimes que parce que je te hais. Mais c'est pas grave.
Good morning. I just wanted to say that
smoking something much like she asked me if I do this every day. I said often. That's how many times you rode the wave, not so often.
I would never do that. That's literally so sus. fuck that got to do with me?
Let me paint you a picture. Jade figures out that she likes coochie. Jade gets kicked out of the house for liking coochie. Parents feel bad for kicking out daughter for liking coochie. But the parents still make sly comments about Jade finding a husband or a boyfriend to give them more grandchildren. So Jade invites Dad to a Speakeasy Tuesday to see black artists at the Houston's Hush Lounge. My dad shows up, but I also had invited a girl. The girl shows up at the same time as the dad shows up. So they walk in together, not knowing each other. There is a poet on stage. She says that she caught two girls kissing in the bathroom and it wasn't me. The father is eyeing Jade and her date the whole night. And when Jade says bye to the girl at the car, Jade kisses her, not realizing that my father was sitting in his car watching us. Good day.
So honestly, I don't really have like a coming out story.
Neither.
But I feel like the first time that I properly realized that I liked girls was in like year 8.
I mean, when I met Sylvia.
Yeah. No, but I remember that I really liked this girl, and she was in a different school. But we were kind of talking as friends, but like my friends at the time knew that I liked her. So I didn't really come out to them. I kind of literally, they basically told me I was gay.
I definitely had some crushes on like primary school friends, but obviously at the time I didn't know what that was.
Yeah.
When I was like 14, that was when I knew, like when I knew.
So you clocked.
Yeah.
Do you like remember when you first like told your mom or?
I ended up just basically being asked by my parents. Like it was
you just knew.
Yeah.
I think the first time that my mum found out was basically I got my heart broken when I was like 14 and I was crying to her about it, so that's probably what happened.
But everybody know now and it's all good.
I don't want to hear that. Because first of all, how do you know? How do you know that that's true? How do you...
Now that we're done with that, you want to see my renegade?
I'm irritated as fuck. I am irritated as fuck. Fuck. Irritated as fuck. Bitch, stay out my business. My.
I'm like so gay, dude.
You don't need a friend, boy, you're the man.
What the fuck?
I have been seeing a bizarre amount of you lovely thumb ladies underneath the comments of pretty girls' posts. Like, oh, I'm not hot, sorry. Like, not hotter. Who gave you that impression? Because in my eyes, patale sudana varadu, okay? பார்த்தாலே அப்படி வந்து வணக்கம் அம்மாஸ் அப்படியே இங்கேருந்து வருது எனக்கு ஓகே இஃப் யூ திங்க் யூர் நாட் ஹாட் ப்ளீஸ் ரீஎவாலுவேட் யுவர் செல்ஃப் ஓகே பிகாஸ் லைக் இஃப் இட் வர் பிட்வீன் யூ அண்ட் மீ கல்யாணம் எப்போ
She my heart, bro, my heart, oh my God. She a thot, yeah, oh God.
Next question.
Tell me a moment from your childhood where it was just very clear that you were gay, but it didn't really add up until right now.
When I was in the third grade, my dad picked me up from school and he said he had a surprise for me. And in the car, there was this big envelope that he said was from across the pond. And I didn't know what that meant because I was in the third grade. And he said that it meant that it was from England. And when we got home, he let me open it. And it was Emma Watson's autograph on a beautiful headshot of her. And naturally, I kissed it goodnight for the entirety of my childhood. And yet, I only came out this year.
Oh no, I hope I don't fall.
Wait, what's the plan tonight? Tonight? Yeah, what's the plan? Amazing question. I guess my question is just like, what is the plan tonight? I'm down to do like whatever you want to do. Okay, well, I'm down to do whatever you want to do. Yeah, I'm down for that. So we'll just do that. That, yeah, okay.
If you wanna suck some wet ass pussy.
This two.
We decided to paint for our date, and I was not expecting fucking Bob Ross. This is what she painted.
How is it so good?
And this is what I painted.
What the fuck?
Why does it look like that?
I don't know if this is a gay thing, but I look at myself and I'm like. Like, the way I would date the shit out of myself right now. I'm actually mad that I can't date myself. Like, I wish I could date me so bad. Do straight people experience having crushes on themselves? Because, am I crazy?
I think you have a little crush on me.
Ew, no.
Yeah, I think you do.
I saw a TikTok that was like, oh, I wish I was feminine, but in the way that men are feminine. And I was like, oh shit. Then I saw another TikTok that was like, oh, well, women probably feel this way because if men are expressing femininity, then it's a form of expression. But if women express femininity, then it's usually for men's pleasure or consumption. And I was like, oh shit. And I realized that whenever I want to dress feminine or feel pretty, I feel like I'm kind of cosplaying femininity. Like, that's exactly it. Like, I just don't want to be sexualized by people that I don't really consent to being sexualized by. I want to be able to express myself and wear makeup and feel cute and pretty without it being for men. I just don't want to be sexualized for trying to feel pretty and look nice. I think that's it.
Even after 3 times he betrayed me.
I follow just about every lesbian stereotype in the book, except for the fact that instead of like a normal job, I nanny. And I enjoy it too.
Something about hiring a dyke to watch your kids.
What's something in your room that tells everyone that you're gay as soon as they walk in?
I will stand by this till the day that I die. Every gay has at least one decorated wall in their room. If it's not one, then it's all the walls in their room. And I know this scientifically because the last girl that I talked to, on one of our FaceTime calls, we did a gay wall tour. This is mine. As you can see, all the requirements are here. A flag of some sort. art that we heavily resonate with for whatever reason. Something that reminds you or that you've received from your ex-girlfriend. The work of a gay artist of some sort. And last, but certainly not least, something that's really not that funny that you think is fucking hilarious.
Also LGB rights, because, you know, I'm gay, so.
I'm not going to sit here next to you because I know you excluded the T on purpose, but I want you to know something. Trans people, especially black trans women, were literally out there protesting and rioting for your little white twink ass to have the right to get married. So next time your transphobic ass is like, transgender isn't a sexuality, why are they included? Disregarding the fact that the queer community is literally for everyone that does not follow heteronormative standards, thank trans people for your basic human right to marry who you love.
Next question.
Infatuated, there's nothing sweet as the flavors of your lips. I think I wanna kiss you. Right here in front of everybody. Right now.
No, I don't think you understand. I'm obsessed.
No, this is not a regular kitchen. This is a lesbian kitchen because it belongs to me, a lesbian, and it's my lesbian kitchen.
I call this scene a lesbian hitting on another lesbian at the bar.
So one time I was at a bar, and as I was leaving, this girl just grabs my arm and she was like, "You are so beautiful. Can I take you on a date?" And I was like, "Yeah." So she called me the next day. We set up drinks. It was a whole thing. And I was like, oh, look at me meeting someone in real life and not on an app. Anyway, so I get to the date and pretty much immediately I was like, oh, God. We just had like nothing in common. And she would answer all my questions just with like nothing. I'd be like, what do you like to do for fun? And she'd be like, I smoke weed. I was like, oh, you know, where are you from? Where'd you grow up? She was just like, NorCal. But finally, she started opening up when I was like, oh, well, like, what do you do for a living? And she was like, yeah, I actually own a beer company with my boyfriend.
Would have came back for you. I just needed time.
Straight hair, straight A's, straight forward, straight girl. Little Miss Perfect.
This is my experience as a person of color on gay TikTok.
Are being targeted, mm-hmm. And you're not a part of a group.
I don't expect you to understand that because you're not a minority.
I'm not a minority? I'm Chinese.
So I bought a shirt with a very specific vision in mind, and I got it today in the mail, and I need to share it with all of you.
Would you like to dance with me? Did you come all this way? Can I get you some tea?
This genuinely feeds too deeply into all of the Prince Charming positions that I self-inserted myself into as a child. This is the best purchase I've ever made. You cannot convince me otherwise. I will not be taking this off, ever. And if you don't like the bow, that's totally fine. So versatile.
Hey, just a femme girl here putting an ad out in the newspaper for a butch lesbian because I can't open this jar. I've been trying for perhaps a man will do as well.
I think you have a little crush on me.
Ew, no.
Yeah, I think you do.
The song is vibrations. I like the beat.
What is pussy talk English?
Wait!
This is the biggest mystery in K-pop.
언니게 파스텔 코랄의 화이트. 무슨 얘기 하시는 거예요?
아, 계속 너무
위에.
I be fresh as fuck when I hit the scene. Everybody know me. 40 tuck in my.
I have never seen two sapphics dating who can both. Who are both good with words. So always one of them gotta be a poet and the other one can't string two words together.
I don't quite know how to put it on the back, but it's okay.
So what is it that you're getting your new girlfriend again, Mom?
Well, this is a chestnut. So it's a chestnut that has a perfect heart in it, and it was shaved off, and this was a piece of wood that a friend cut for me. And both of these were found in areas that we have hiked, and so I'm going to see if I can make a Christmas decoration.
That's all it takes. That's all it takes to make women happy. Just a pretty stick. Pretty stick that you found on a walk.
Women who enjoy nature.
That's like all women.
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
Room that tells everyone that you're gay as soon as they walk in.
I will stand by this till the day that I die. Every gay has at least one decorated wall in their room. If it's not one, then it's all the walls in their room. And I know this scientifically because the last girl that I talked to, on one of our FaceTime calls, we did a gay wall tour. This is mine. As you can see, all the requirements are here. A flag of some sort. Art that we heavily resonate with for whatever reason. Something that reminds you or that you've received from your ex-girlfriend. The work of a gay artist of some sort. And last, but certainly not least, something that's really not that funny that you think is fucking hilarious.
Straight girls be like,
oh my god, I love you so much, you're so hot. Maybe we should get on a date, maybe we should make out, maybe we should have sex, maybe we should get a cat together, maybe we should get married.
But then they'd be like, why would you assume I'm gay? I'm not a fucking dumb.
Baby, you my everything. You all I ever wanted. We could do it real big. Bigger than you ever done it. You be up on everything. Other hoes ain't never on it. I want this forever. I swear I could spend whatever on it. Cause she hold me down every time I.
All this goddamn eyeliner. And still no gaslighting gamer boy.
DF.
Honestly, a woman really does not have to do much to impress me. Genuinely, if a woman is around me and she breathes, I'm like, yeah. But if a man is around me and he breathes?
I'm a Republican voting for Mitt Romney. You lazy bitches is fucking up the economy.
What's Gibby thinking about?
Internalized homophobia. 1. What the fuck? 2. Why does nobody warn you about it? 3. What the fuck? You're telling me that I'm homophobic towards myself because of what society thinks about me. Huh? No, 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 no. That is fucked up. Okay? Also, everyone's always like, oh, once you come out, smiles, rainbows, butterflies, happiness, so much better, no more depression. No. Yes, it's a little easier being out here than it is being shoved in that little closet that I was for the first 18 years of my life, but it is not easier. I'm unpacking trauma. I'm trying to find a new identity. I'm introducing that identity to myself. I'm introducing the new identity to other people. I'm making sure they like it. I'm still having to come out, like, all throughout my life. Like, it's not just one time, too. It's just...
I can't talk right now. I'm doing sad gay shit.
And I was catching my breath.
How the fuck did you figure this out? Because I'm literally so confused. I have no fucking clue.
Great question. I had spent my whole life liking boys, having crushes on boys, you know? I'd even had a boyfriend at some point. But honestly, it was the moment I was with a girl. I'm not talking sex, we hadn't even kissed, but it was just what I felt for her. Without us even, like, actually dating, it was just so little that made me feel so much, and I just fucking knew, like, this is what it's supposed to be, and it had never been like that with any man. I felt it in my bones. I was sure this is who I am. I've been an out and proud lesbian for 6 years.
Mask lesbians will wear a fit like this every single day and be like, who want me? Bitch, me. I want you.
Okay, in every queer relationship, there is a sun and there's a moon, and I'm going to show you examples first and then explain after. Sun, moon. Moon, sun. Sun, moon. Sun, moon. So basically, the sun is the person who is, I guess, more social, more exuberant, kind of exudes a brighter energy. The moon is the person who's a little bit more reserved to themselves and has sort of like a subtle emotional brooding energy sometimes. So think cottagecore versus goth girl. Also, this is based solely off of perception, so if someone's perceived to be happier, brighter, they could still be the sadder one, and that's okay. They're still perceived as the sun.
I do not care what anyone says. It's not a good movie if there's no scissoring. If there's no scissoring, don't tell me to watch a movie. I'm not watching Interstellar.
I'm conditioning you.
I'm not buying.
And I'm not buying it. I kissed a girl. I liked it.
Ha ha, ha ha, ha ha. Oh, women. I have clearly misread my target audience.
Legs monkey, village speaks righteous, sister Cena says funky, how bizarre, how bizarre, how bizarre.
Next question.
It's a sweet word. The table is prepared for you. Ooh.
It's almost like that's the whole point.
So the other day I was telling a family member about the lesbian dating experience, and I told him that I've only ever had my dating app set to women. So I have never been on straight Tinder, straight Hinge, anything. Lesbian only. Even though I'm technically bi with a heavy female preference. And he was like, how come? And then I was like, listen, if I wanted to meet a man, I would open my front door. Now, women, on the other hand.
Probably one of the funniest comments I'm getting is people being like, oh, the boys are gonna love that. Oh, men love that. Oh, your boyfriend's gonna have fun with that. I'm a lesbian.